Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 40. Apple is constantly working on improving Siri with Erling and Whispering Bean, one of the things we might see in future update. Presently, whenever you ask Siri, you will get a response in a preset noise level and no variation in tone whatsoever. But according to the patent application via Apple Insider, Apple will teach Siri a new trick when a voice instance could respond with a yell or a whisper based on environmental condition. What this means is simple. If it is late at night and you ask Siri something, the assistant will reply back in calm and gentle voice suited for the environment. But if you are in a train or some other noisy place, then Siri will amp up the volume and tone to make things more audible. Samsung Galaxy A52 5G India launch seems imminent as handset gets spotted on BIS certification. Samsung Galaxy A52 5G key specifications include a 120Hz Super AMOLED display, a 64MP primary camera, and a 4500mAh battery. Samsung has just teased the launch of two new entry-level smartphones on Flipkart, the Galaxy M02s and Galaxy F12. Both devices are appeared to be a refreshed version of Samsung Galaxy M02s and Galaxy M12. Respectively, that were launched earlier this year, Flipkart has also teased some key specifications of these two mobiles, such as screen sizes, refresh rate, camera configurations, and battery. The launch date for these two mobiles was set for April 15th. Let's see some of the specifications of Samsung Galaxy F02s. It comes with a 6.5-inch HD+ screen with a V-shaped notch, and it is also powered by 5000mAh battery, and at the back there will be three rear cameras superheaded by a 13MP primary sensor. Lastly, the smartphone will run on a Qualcomm Snapdragon 450 chipset. We can expect it to max out of 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. Moving on to Samsung Galaxy F12 specifications, we get the same 6.5-inch HD+ screen, and also it has a refresh rate of 90Hz. At the back, there is a 48MP ISOCELL GM2 sensor accompanied with three other. We probably looking at ultra wide angle lens, macro and depth sensor. Samsung has revealed nothing more about this device. Samsung TV Plus service has been launched in India, and it offers consumers with Samsung Smart TV's free TV content with ad support, selected live channels and on-demand videos. This doesn't require an additional device such as set-top box, as it just needs consumers to have a Samsung Smart TV, that is 2017 model onwards, and an internet connection. This brings a variety of content across genres such as news, lifestyle, technology, gaming, science, sports and outdoor music, and shows without any subscription. With the launch in India, Samsung TV Plus is now available in 14 countries including US, Canada, Korea, Switzerland, Germany, Austria, UK, Italy, France, Spain, Australia, Brazil and Mexico. Samsung Galaxy A Quantum 2 is widely believed to launch in most markets as Samsung Galaxy A82 5G. To recall, the first Galaxy A Quantum phone was launched as rebranded Galaxy A71. We have now spotted the Galaxy A Quantum 2 on the Google Play console listing with a model code name and a model number, which reaffirmed that it will be called as Samsung Galaxy A82 5G. Some of the expected specifications of this mobile are: it comes with Snapdragon 855 Plus chipset, and it has a full HD Plus display, and comes with 64MP Sony IMX686 primary camera, and it also comes with 6GB of RAM. Railway will tell passengers not to charge laptops and phones at night. You will soon not be able to charge your phone on a train. The restriction on phone charging will be between 11 PM and 5 AM. The Indian Railways found overcharging of devices caused minor fires on trains. Xiaomi has recently launched its Mi 11 Pro and Mi 11 Ultra smartphones during the company's mega launch event last week, alongside a slew of other products including the Mi Smart Band 6, Mi 11 Lite 5G and more devices. Mi 11 Ultra and Mi 11 Pro went on sale in China earlier this week, and Xiaomi has now announced that Mi 11 Pro and Mi 11 Ultra generated about roughly 1340 crores in just first minute of the sale. That's an astonishing number, and instantly remind us the time Xiaomi set foot in the country with smartphone selling across platform within seconds. Mi 11 Ultra India launch date has been revealed just a few days after the flagship phone's debut in China. Xiaomi has revealed that the Mi 11 Ultra will launch in India later this month on April 23rd. The premium smartphone from the company is notable for offering a secondary screen on the back. The device also comes with the high-end specifications including the Snapdragon 888 chipset, 2K 120Hz AMOLED display and a 50 megapixel triple rear camera. Ahead of the launch event, here is a quick look at the Mi 11 Ultra's expected price in India and the complete specifications. Mi 11 Ultra price in India will be officially revealed on April 23rd. However, we can speculate the India price based on the phone's pricing in China. The flagship has been launched in China at a starting price at 67,000 rupees for 8GB RAM and 256GB storage variant. And 12GB RAM and 256GB storage variant is available for 72,500 rupees. And 12GB RAM and 512GB storage variant is available for 78,100 rupees. Mi 11 Ultra sport a 6.81-inch 2K AMOLED display with a 120Hz refresh rate and HDR10+ Dolby Vision support and a Goring Gorilla Glass Victus on top. The flagship is powered by the Snapdragon 888 chipset paired with up to 12GB of RAM and 512GB of internal storage. This handset packs a 5000mAh battery with 67W fast wired and wireless charging support. Mi 11 Ultra runs on Android 11 based MIUI 12. Interestingly, the Mi 11 Ultra comes with a small secondary screen on the rear camera module. This screen can be used to capture selfies using the rear camera. Speaking of this camera, Mi 11 Ultra comes with a 50 megapixel primary camera and a 48 megapixel of telephoto camera with 120x digital zoom support and a 48 megapixel of wide angle lens, and there is a 20 megapixel front facing camera as well. Flipkart is giving a discount of ₹8,000 for Poco X3 Pro. Poco X3 Pro price in India is down to ₹10,999 for the 6GB and 128GB variant and ₹12,999 for 8GB and 128GB model after exchange discount. Poco X3 Pro upgrade program has been announced for Poco F1 users. The company is offering up to ₹7,000 exchange value on Poco F1. The Flipkart is offering additional ₹1,000 instant discount with ICICI Bank credit cards and EMI transactions. Vivo has launched its cheaper version of X60 series smartphone, the Vivo X60, in China. After the Vivo X60 smartphone that was launched back in December last year in China, which is powered by Samsung Exynos 1080 SoC instead of the global version that has Snapdragon 870 SoC. Vivo X60T runs on MediaTek Dimensity 1100 SoC and the other specifications remain the same. It has a 6.56-inch Full HD Plus E3 AMOLED screen with support HDR10+, 120Hz refresh rate and 240Hz touch sampling rate, and it has 92.7% of screen to body ratio. In addition, it comes with 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage and works on the latest Origin OS 1.0 based on Android 11. Facebook owned popular instant messaging platform WhatsApp is reportedly working on a new feature that will allow users to change colors inside an application. According to a tweet by WhatsApp feature tracker, WhatsApp Beta Info, with the help of this feature, the app users will be able to change colors in the chat box and opt for a darker shade of green for text on the screen. There is no official word yet on when the feature is expected to roll out to all the users. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.